Hello, investors. This is Jake with Jake Markets, checking in with you today live on Instagram. Also checking in with you maybe on a recording later. You might see this a little bit later. And what we're discussing here today is why your real estate business needs to be on Instagram. So whether you are a realtor or an investor, we're going to discuss why you need to be on Instagram. Right? How to identify, engage, and convert your target audience. How to find motivated sellers is what we're all looking for here. So a little bit about me. My name is Jake. I've spent the last 4 years training investors in online marketing. I've coached over 5,000 real estate investors, delivered dozens of live webinars, just like I'm doing right now, in front of thousands of people. And I have developed some online marketing curriculum. So if you are interested in learning more about that, definitely send me an email here, jake@jakemarkets.com. For the last 10 years, I have been online marketing. So I am very passionate about this field. This has been my life. I've done everything from email to Facebook ads to TV and radio media buys, affiliate marketing. I brokered over $1 million in affiliate marketing deals. And, you know, I just know what converts. I have done, you know, done it all, basically. Right now, my newest obsession is Instagram. I started this account a couple of years ago, November of 2019. Right now, it's October of 2021. So coming up on 2 years, National Parks Pros, you can see them over 125,000 followers. And that is all organic growth. You can go check that account out right now. Those are all engaged followers. No one is fake. No one is bought. I never bought a single follower on Instagram in my entire life. And how I got here and how I got it to 125,000 plus is just by testing over and over and over again, finding out what works, right? I started out doing just a very basic travel account, National Parks Pro is what it was. It was photos of me and my girlfriend going to maybe a handful of national parks, really not that many, just probably 5 or 10. And what I did is I was able to grow that account using Instagram, using just stock photos from Canva or Unsplash. And I was also able to use user-generated content, which I'll definitely get into a little bit more here. And I became obsessed with the platform and learning how to grow my account here and really just utilizing this algorithm to not only get followers, but to convert those followers into an email list and to paid customers as well. And now on this account, I have been paid by Instagram. Instagram has paid me to do live videos just like I'm doing right now on Jake Markets. So why Instagram? Why not some of these other platforms, right? Why not Facebook? Why not Twitter? Why not TikTok, which is a massive, massive craze right now, right? Why not YouTube or anything else that pops up? Well, let's go through those platforms one by one here. And I've tested all of these different platforms and how to grow your audience there in 2021 and potentially beyond. And on Facebook in particular, what's difficult to grow your audience there? Well, it's just, I would say almost impossible to do it organically now. On Facebook, basically what you're doing is you have to pay to get traffic there. You can't just throw up a post on your Facebook business page and expect to get followers this day and age. You have to pay Facebook to run paid ads or boost posts. There's a bunch of different ways that Facebook will take your money, right? But that's what you want to do, is you have to pay Facebook to get in front of your target audience. So it's really difficult to do it organically on Facebook. Twitter is pretty much the same thing. Twitter is more for personal brands than anything else. It's really difficult for a business to get much traction on Twitter. You have to be like a big personality. You have to have a following already. TikTok? Well, TikTok is great. You can grow an audience very quickly on TikTok. The only problem is that especially with real estate, your audience is just not the right demographic, right? TikTok is a little bit younger. You're going to find a lot of high school kids in there, a lot of people in their 20s. If you're doing a lot of rental stuff, I do recommend you have a TikTok account and build your audience there. That is your demographic. But for the most part, if you're looking to target motivated sellers and homeowners looking to sell or buy new homes, I'm not sure if TikTok is going to be the platform right this second. Now, 5 years from now, that could easily change. Heck, a year from now, that could easily change. But TikTok right this moment, you know, we'll keep an eye on it. But right this moment, it's just not the homeowner demographic. YouTube is great. You can actually get paid to grow your YouTube account. Only problem is it takes an incredibly long time. It takes a very long time to grow your YouTube account. If you don't believe me, go ahead and start one up and try it and beg all your friends and family to subscribe to your channel and see how far you get and put up 10, 20 videos and see what happens, right? It just takes a very long time to grow your YouTube channel. So why Instagram is great is because you can just grow it so much more quickly and it has the right demographic. So many reasons, and they're building it out for business, right? Look at these stats right here, guys. Instagram data has 15 to 20 times the engagement than that of Facebook or Twitter. That's pretty crazy, guys. 15 to 20 times the engagement on Instagram. And if you don't believe me, put up a post on your Facebook business page, put up a post on Instagram and see how much engagement you get. Those numbers are spot on. Right, 23% increase in 2020 in usage, and it's expected to be even bigger in 2021, right? Due to coronavirus, people are sitting home. TikTok has seen the same explosive growth. People want to sit there and watch videos all day. That's the culture, short form videos. That's what people want to see, right? So Instagram users spend an average of 53 minutes per day on the platform. That's significant. People are on their phones, guys. People are on this app. You guys are watching it right now. I have two people who are waving at me, right? So there are people on here who are waiting to engage with businesses. 50% of Instagrammers follow at least one business. So they will interact with the business. They will engage, right? And Instagram helps 80% of Instagram users decide to buy a product or service. That's pretty crazy, right? 80% of Instagram users are assisted by Instagram in buying a product or service. So Instagram wants you to make money, right? The users want you to reach out and find them. They want your service, right? They want to learn about you and your business. And you obviously want to be on Instagram, right? So it's win, win, win. All we have to do is just play by the rules and you can grow your account there and see significant results. It doesn't take a lot of users to start making money there. So Instagram growth, look at these users. These are in millions, right? So in 2021, it passed 1 billion users on this platform, which is incredibly significant. Now, if you think about all the people in the world, there's roughly about 7 billion people on the world. And I think you have to be over 13 or 14 to be on Instagram. And, you know, if you cut out everyone who was over 80 plus or 70 plus, who was not even on social media in general, that's a lot of people. That's maybe one out of every 3-4 people is really on Instagram that can be. So it's massive. Right? It's only getting larger and larger, as you guys see here, every year or so it grows significantly. So now that we're sold on Instagram, right, what do we do here to grow your platform? And why does it matter for real estate investors and realtors to do these things, right? Well, before we even do anything, we have to do our research, right? We have to know what we're going to do. We can't just throw up a bunch of posts and expect them to perform well. So you have to do the research first. And there's a lot of different elements, surprisingly, that we have to research here on Instagram before we start posting. The first one's going to be hashtags. How many hashtags do we use? What types of hashtags do we use? Do we use local hashtags? Where do we put them? All of these different questions about hashtags, right? We have to analyze our competitors. That is very, very significant. That's the first thing that we should do, is find our competitors in our market, see what they're doing, see what's working well, see what hashtags they're doing, see what types of reels they're doing, see what types of stories they're putting out there, see what types of value adds they're providing for their audience. And then now we have a blueprint for success in our area. So finding those competitors is the lowest hanging fruit. That's the easiest thing to do, to find that blueprint for real estate investing or becoming a very successful, growing your real estate business on Instagram, right? We have to do that niche research on real estate, see what reels are performing well, see what reels are kind of bombing, see if there's any trends we can jump on really quickly to grow our account significantly, almost overnight. I have seen accounts jump 1,000 followers with one post. I've done it myself. I've seen other accounts do it. It's definitely possible, right? So we have to do that research first so we know what we're going to post. And then after we've done that and we have a good template and a good blueprint, now we have to post very frequently. You have to be on the platform, right? That's what Instagram wants to see. You have to think in the mind of Instagram, keep the platform happy and they will return you with followers, right? That's how they're going to reward you, because they know you're going to take care of them. So posting often is the most important thing you can do, is just post content and post high quality content, right? You're not just going to throw up a bunch of garbage and put trash hashtags in there and expect it to perform well. So you have to post often and you have to have high quality content, right? Content is king. Have you guys ever heard that before? Content is king. Very, very important. So you have to have high quality content. It's very easy to create that content, outsource it, go to Canva and create some stuff there. A lot of different ways to create that content, stock photos, before and afters, anything you guys have. But the more posts you create, the more followers you're going to get. It's really that simple. You're going to get impressions. You're going to get comments on those posts. And when you do start to get comments on your posts and messages in your inbox, which you will, you want to follow up. That engagement is crucial, right? That's the follow-up, right? The post step is to engage with your audience. Make sure that you're taking care of them. And that's a separate algorithm that Instagram uses to track how good of an account you are, right? If you're following up on every single DM that you get and every single comment that you receive, Instagram will send you more followers. I've seen it. I have case studies. I can prove it, you guys. It's a no-brainer. Engage with your audience. That's what Instagram wants to see. That's what your audience wants. That's how you're going to make sales. So what should you research on Instagram, right? I talked about these a little bit: competitors, hashtags, niche trends, and your market. So let's dive into those a little bit more. So competitor research. If you're in the real estate industry, if you're a realtor or an investor, the easiest thing to do, the lowest hanging fruit, is to find a local realtor in your area who is doing really well. They have a few thousand followers. Maybe if you're in a smaller, more rural area, you might just need 1,000, 2,000 followers plus. If you're in a bigger market, then you should have no problem finding some realtors who are really crushing it. Find out what they're doing. Follow them. And then after you hit the follow button, if you do this on mobile, you're going to see a way to add them as a close friend. So that's a first hack right there, is to add your competitors as a close friend, right? Keep your friends close and your enemies closer. So that's how you want to play it. See what they're doing. And that way you can just continue to spy on them for trends and hashtags and everything else that follows here. So hashtags, what you're able to do with these is you're able to use 30 in every single post. Now, should you use 30 in every single post is a different question. And there's been, especially recently, a lot of debate about this. And Instagram has actually came out and said you are better off using fewer hashtags just because people don't really know how to use them properly. People misuse them. They use the same exact 30 hashtags in every single post, even though their posts vary quite a bit. So you don't want to use the same 30 posts, just copy and paste and spit those out. It's like spamming, it's scam, right? It's not legit, right? You need to do more work and use fewer hashtags and make them very specific to every single post that you make. So you're better off using 5 to 10 to maybe 15 hashtags and make sure they are very, very specific to what you're discussing. So if you're in the real estate niche and industry, you want to use a nice mix of very general real estate hashtags and local hashtags. That's huge. Local hashtags in real estate can build your following and get you the right audience really quickly, right? If you want to target the right audience and get granular, local hashtags is one really great way to do that. And do niche research as well, right? See what people are doing in the real estate industry outside of your market. That way you can take those strategies and you can apply them to your market. And you can use local hashtags, right? And if you're following local realtors, they're going to see those and they're going to say, wow, this is great content. Let's reach out. You're going to get more DMs. You're going to get more engagement. It's that simple. So you want to see what's going on in other accounts that are growing massively, see what the newest features are on Instagram. Right now it's Reels and live video. So you want to be doing those to grow your account and doing real estate related activities on there, growing your account. So if you have projects you're working on, new listings, a house you're staging, whatever it is, just make sure and do live videos and showcase what's going on. That's huge for account growth. And local market research, right? What's going on right now in your local market? Maybe inside and outside of real estate. Are there any better business bureaus you can find and join and follow? Are there any, and sometimes in bigger markets, there are accounts like, you know, if you're in the San Diego market, you can find massive San Diego accounts and join them and maybe get some of your posts shared with them and reach a bigger audience that way, right? So you can see what's going on in your local market, maybe local restaurants. If they're having a thing, you can go and tag yourself and, you know, get more engagement that way. So see what's going on in your local market. And the more you're plugged in with that local community, the more likely you are to find homeowners. And that's who you're really looking to connect with if you want to make money using Instagram and real estate. Or finding lenders as well down the road. So what are the different post types on Instagram, right? So if we look at these slides here, we have single image posts, we have carousels, we have stories, we have reels, and we have Instagram TV. And we also have IG Live, which is what I'm doing right now, right? So let's look at a few of these here. Single image posts. These are your bread and butter. These are the most simple form of Instagram post you can make. Most simple form of Instagram content you can create. So the purpose of this is to get new followers, to get you impressions. People who are going to see these posts, if you look up here, you see I have, first of all, this is a tag, right? This is a geolocation tag. So people can click on Washington, D.C., and my post will come up if they click on that, or if they click on that anywhere else, all the posts that have that geo tag will show up. So for local businesses, this is massive. You want to make sure and have that geo tag in every single post you make. because it's going to get you the more targeted audience that you really need in real estate, right? So who else sees this post? People who are already my followers. So Jake Markets has about 700 followers now. So anyone who is following me, a certain percentage of them will see my post. And if they like it and engage with it and comment on it, then Instagram will show it to a higher and higher and higher percentage. And it will keep just going and going the more engagement I get. And that's how Instagram determines how a post goes viral, so to speak, is how many people engage with that post right out of the gate. And then the more people it shows it to, you know, the higher that engagement rate is, the more traction you're going to get. Hashtags. Also, that's another way people will see your post there. So you'll, again, put in about 5 or 10 hashtags using those local hashtags. That's massive. And you will get some really good engagement and high quality followers using that strategy. So those are going to be the main ways that people actually see these single image posts. All right. Then we have Reels. Reels are a great way to build your audience as well. So Reels are the number one strategy, I'd say, right now for growing your account on Instagram. It's also the newest feature, so to speak. Reels were created to rival TikTok, the short form video content that's about 10 to 15 seconds, maybe even 30 to 60 seconds. But short form video that is designed to be like a cell phone, right? Shot straight up and down like this, not the other way, like a YouTube video or like maybe like a movie would be. This is just like first person recording something, very easy to record. So that's what a reel is. This is the best way to grow your account. Doing funny things like this guy is doing here is a great strategy. Doing face to camera is massive right now. Providing value is the way to go. You have to provide value somehow. It has to be educational or entertaining. So ideally, it's going to be both. But think edutainment, right? It's got to be funny. It's got to be entertaining. If you can do both, then you're doing great. But if you're not doing either, then you're doing nothing, right? So reels are a great way to go. You should be producing reels maybe a few times a week. 3 to 4 times a week is a great number to strive for. Again, see what those local trends are. See what other real estate trends are. And that's going to give you content ideas. And then we have carousels. Carousels are also massive right now. They are designed to demonstrate value, to educate people. If you see up here, this one has 4 different images. You can swipe through. If you were to swipe right here, you would see some good information that they're providing. And that's how you want to use carousels. If you click this button right here, you can save that post for later. And that should be your main call to action with carousels, is to get saves. Again, Instagram really sees that as a great metric for engagement. If you're getting a lot of saves, then Instagram will just throw followers your way and you will see huge spikes in engagement rates and following and everything else. If you create this educational content and get saves and target that metric as something that you're going after as one of your KPIs. And then we have stories, right? So stories are usually only seen by your audience. And stories aren't really designed to get you more followers per se. What they're really designed to do is develop your audience, get them from follower to lead. And what we mean by lead is getting their data, getting them to engage with enough content by taking a survey or doing a poll or answering a question. And then maybe going from a piece of content like that to like a lead magnet, where you're collecting their email address, where you're giving away like an ebook, or you're doing like a giveaway for a cool product that has significant value, like $100 or more. And you do that maybe once a month. That's going to be how you convert your followers into leads and having some software set up on the back end to collect that data. So getting email addresses is, of course, huge. Getting phone numbers is even bigger right now. SMS is really starting to take off. So getting phone numbers is the way to go. Try to collect as many people's phone numbers as you can. Stories are a great place to initiate that conversation and convert them from follower into a lead, into an SMS subscriber. And again, you have to provide more value. The more value you provide, the easier it's going to be for them to take that leap. So ebooks, giveaways, anything else you can think of, free consultations, just to get a phone number. And then IGTV, this is great. And I heard this might be going away, so I might have to update my slide deck now. But basically IGTV is any video that's longer than a reel. And it's more longer form content. So think more educational videos, not those short, not TikTok stuff, more YouTube stuff, right? So that's the way you want to go with IGTV. Have a good game plan in mind. Usually 10 to 15 minutes is a good range for this type of content, but highly educational. You're doing like an interview, you're walking through one of your projects, you have a new listing and you're really doing a high level showcase of it. That's what you want to use IGTV for. All right. So what else on Instagram matters besides posting, right? We already know content is super important, but there's surprisingly a lot else you can do on Instagram, and they're developing that platform even more. So there's going to be even more and more stuff you can do on this platform, which is great. So the first few things that you want to do here is optimize your bio, get some type of link tree set up in your account, and focus on engagement, as I said, after the content goes out. So let's take a closer look at these here. Optimizing your bio. There's a couple of really cool things you can do here. The first one is, you know, include these three sentences, right? Who we are, what we do, a call to action. So that's how you typically optimize your bio. You want people to know right off the bat what industry you're in, that they're in the right place, right? What industry you're in, what niche you're in, the location is there if you're a local business, right? This is a San Diego-based business. You know, your target market areas. I can talk about Southern California. And who you're going after, who you're providing value for, contractors, realtors, rehabbers, lenders. And I have some cute little emojis in there that kind of move the story along. And then you always want to end this with a call to action. Click here to connect. So you can click there and it goes to a link tree, which is the next cool little feature here. Right? We have a link tree, which creates several different links that your audience can go to. It spreads them out because in Instagram, you can only have one link in your profile. So they'll click that one link and then, you know, where do they go from there? We can only send them maybe to your homepage. Well, they can get pretty lost on a website homepage. Do we put them in the contact us page? You know, or if we run something cool like an offer or a special, we don't have to keep updating this link to go to all of these different locations, right? We can just update our link tree and add and subtract and hide these cool buttons here. So Linktree is a free service. It's really awesome. What it does is basically it's like a free landing page that will divide and make your audience go to the right page, right? So now you have four or five different landing pages set up here, one for maybe a contest, one for, you know, learning more about us, one here for sellers, one for buyers, one for realtors, one for contractors. This is set up as an investor. You know, if you're a realtor, maybe you have one for sell a home, buy a home, you know, testimonials about me. Right, you can have these different buttons set up and it will go to those pages. And each one of those has a call to action that's more appropriate for that audience, and maybe even like an ebook, or, you know, a good way to build your list more quickly. So optimizing your bio and creating an effective link tree is a great way just in and of itself to get more leads. A lot of people don't have that set up effectively. They don't have call to action set up, or they don't use call to actions in their posts, right? When you create a post, you should say, visit our bio for more information. If you're a realtor, click the link in our bio and get the free ebook, right? Or, you know, get more leads by working with investors. Learn how to do that by sending us an email, or, right? You want to use a call to action that's going to get people to go down your funnel and ultimately develop more leads. So having this set up on the back end is really important when you make posts and you make reels. So that way you can use your call to actions more effectively. So after the post goes out, right, we have engagement. And this is incredibly important on Instagram, right? If content is king, then engagement is queen. And I'm pretty sure I coined that, so no one steal that, because I'm a chess player and I know the queen is the most powerful player on the board, right? So this is so critically important. It's honestly where most businesses fail, not only on social media, but everywhere else, right? They get an email, they get someone that'll reach out and engage, and they don't follow up. They just don't follow up. They don't put the work in to engage and build a relationship. And I don't know what it is, but this is where most businesses fail in general, on the follow-up. So engage with them on Instagram. When people comment, respond to every single comment you get. When people message you, respond to every single message you get. And the faster you do that, the more Instagram likes your account, the more followers you're going to get, the higher it's going to boost your account. You're just going to be winning faster if you engage with your audience. You're also going to be able to convert that audience into a paid client faster. It's that simple. You have to engage with them. You have to use stories. You have to use messages to engage and convert your audience. That's critical, right? So a lot of people, and I was guilty of this as well as I was growing my accounts, is that they spend so much time focused on growth that they forget to reply to comments or messages. So make sure you respond to, again, every single comment that comes your way, every single message that comes your way, because the goal on Instagram and in business in general is to make money, right? Not to get a bunch of people in your store and then just hang out there and comment on how cool it is. You want them to buy stuff, right? You want them to come to you and list their property with you. You want them to come there and sell their property to you. You want them to come there and ask you questions and engage, right? And you provide tons of value, and now you're making a lot of money with them. So engagement is so critical. Make sure you guys are doing this on a regular basis, right? So what do I do and how can I help? Well, I actually also, manage accounts on the side, not only for investors, but for realtors here. And these are the different options that come with it, so to speak, right? This is on the fulfillment side, what you would receive. So you would get 45 posts each month, geolocation targeted, 15 hashtags in each post, a unique signature created for your brand, right? You get a fully optimized bio, turning leads into money. We already saw how critically important that is. You're going to get all the research that you need, the hashtags, the local competitors, the local market trends, reels trends, all that research done for you. You're going to have the engagement done for you after the post, replying to comments, replying to DMs, competitor comments, commenting on those to convert your competitors' audience into your audience, and also doing the same thing for hashtags that your audience might be following. And then also we have audience outreach that I'll do for you, where I target the local audience in your area that you're going for, right? Homeowners, lenders, if you're a realtor, lenders, if you're an investor, contractors, if you're an investor, motivated sellers, regardless, right? Inbound leads coming in. If you're a realtor, you might get new leads from investors. If you're an investor, you'll probably get new leads from realtors. That's the way you want to work it. You want to work it from both sides, right? Realtor and money leads. So you'll get leads on the investing side, and you will get money leads as well from lenders. And monthly analytics, how many impressions you got, how many likes, comments, saves. We can even go as far as, you know, leads and DMs, whatever you need. And what I tell people at this point is, you know, think of it as digital real estate. And right now is a free land grab. And your competitors are going after it, right? Are you going to beat them to it? Are you going to just let people in your market swoop up this Instagram land that is free to develop where there's tons of engagement and people are buying and it's growing massively? Or are you going to get in there first and, you know, swoop that up, right? So if you have questions or if you want to learn more about my services or, you know, if you just want to do a call with me, reach out. Here's my information. It's Jake at jakemarkets.com. Very simple, right? Jake at jakemarkets.com. Yeah, so send me a quick email, reach out, and we'll get this thing going. We can either do consultations, I can do account management for you. We'll discuss it, but either way, I can help you grow on Instagram. So thank you guys so much for your time. I'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you.